Hey, 大家好，我是李贝。All right, let's continue reading《猫城记》by 老舍。where were we? All right. So we crash landed on Mars. We've met our friend 大仙。大仙is a cat person. he sort of helped us, but we're finding out he's maybe not as great as we first thought.And what else do we need to know? So I want to find my independence. I'm kind of his servant at the moment, and I want my independence. So we're getting more and more tension. So this is going to come to, come to a climax at some point soon. And so what happened was I went...swimming to have a shower. I'm trying to not eat the mie, the narcotic leaf that everyone eats. I went swimming. A whole bunch of cat people started watching me. I'm kind of utilizing this as an opportunity to, assert my independence, I guess. All right, let's go. Wabba.大仙拿住，看他这个笑，向来没看见过他笑得这么厉害。我越生气，他越笑。似乎猫人的笑是专为避免挨打预备着的。我问他，教人参观我洗澡的是什么意思？他不说，只是一劲的没笑。我知道他心中有鬼，但是不愿看他的贱样子。贱 ，I think it means lowly or something here, right? I don't encounter that character very often.只告诉他以后再有这种举动留神你的头皮。Alright, so I do not trust my friend, 大仙, very suspicious. Okay. Yeah, he's probably up to shenanigans, and I'm trying to exert my freedom. 第二天我依旧到河上去，还没到沙滩，我一看见黑乎乎的一群，比昨天的还多。我决定不动声色地洗我的澡。一遍看看到底是怎么回事，回去再和大仙算账。太阳出来了，我站在水前处，一边假装打水，一边看着他们。大仙在那儿呢，带着一个猫人。双手大概捧着一大堆迷叶，堆的顶住下巴。大仙在前，拿迷叶的猫人在后。大仙一伸手，那猫人一伸手，顺着那堆猫人走。猫人手中的迷叶渐渐的减小了。我明白了，大仙借着机会卖些迷叶，而且毕竟卖得很贵。All right, so I'm having my bath and my friend 大仙，大仙 is flogging the 迷叶 the narcotic leaves. 我本是个有点幽默的人，但是一时的怒气往往使人的行为失于 What's that? what is that character? What is that? Let's look it up. I guess it's 偏激 or something like this. 偏激 No. put it in by hand. Something like that. So I'll do it more carefully this time. So it is this one and this one. Ian. Kenji. Narrow-minded, short-tempered. Kenji. I don't know this character. Wen. So that's a... like written language, xia jai xia, oh xia xia, in xia. All right. We just wanted to. Well, I wanted to pause and have a look at a character. Where were we? Xu Bian, Bian Ji, Xu Bian Ji. 某人的怎样怕我，只因为我是个外国人，我是知道的。 这一定全是那些的坏主意，我也知道，为惩罚那些一个人而使那群无辜的猫人连带的受点损失，不是我的本意，可是 Sorry, I need to put my copy over here. 可是，那时候怒气使我忘了一切体谅，我必须使大些知道我的厉害，不然我永远不用再想安静的享受这早晨的运动，自然。 若猫人们也在早晨来游泳。哦，猫人们。 So the story said that they didn't like water, but now they're swimming. I'm a little confused about that. 我便无话可讲，这条河不是我独有的，不过一个人。It's that word again, isn't it? I forget. Shemeshri. It's like swimming or something like that, right? Maybe diving into the water or something like that.
几百人等着看，而且有借此做买卖的，我不能忍受。
Why? Why? Why do you... Like, that's literally how you've survived on Mars. Alright, anyway.
我不想先捉住那些，他不告诉我实话，我必须捉住一个参观人，去问个分明。我先慢慢的往河岸那边退，背朝着他们，以免他们骑到了河岸。我想，我跑个白马。
出其不备的捉住个猫人。 All right, so we want to surprise and catch one of these, my audience. They're watching me bathe. Yeah.
到了河岸。 刚一转过脸来，听见一声极惨的呼声，呼喊，比杀猪的声还难听。我的白马开始，眼前就如同忽然地震一般，那样那群猫人要各自逃命，又要往一处挤，跑的。 倒的，忘了跑的，跑的倒的，忘了跑的，倒下，又往起爬的，同时并举，一眨眼，全没了，好像被风吹散的一些落叶。 这里小团，那里小团，东边一个，西边两个，一边跑一边喊，好像都失了云。几句。It is 几句。Why is it 几句 ？Not like 哪一句 ？Or something like this. 几句。Maybe I should know what this means. It's like, 几句我的白马跑完，地上只躺着几个了。我捉了一个，一看，眼已闭上，没气了。我的后悔比闯入我的后悔比闯了祸的恐怖大得多。我不应当这么利用自己的优越而杀了人，但是我并没呆住，好似不自觉的又捉住另一个。哇，腿坏了 ，sorry， 腿坏了，可是没死。在事后想起来，我真不佩服我自己，分明看见人家腿坏了，而还去捉住他审问，分明看见有一个已吓死，而。还去捉个半死的，说若不自觉是可原谅的。人性本善，便无可成逆了。All right, so my plan hasn't gone off without a hitch. It's a bit of an issue, but.We need to exert our independence.
学半死的猫人说话，像个外国人说话是天下最难的事。我知道，一定叫他出生是等于杀人的。他必会不久的，他必会不久的也被吓死。可怜的猫人，我放了他。再看，那几个倒着的，身上当然都受了伤，都在地上爬呢，爬得很快。我没去追他们，有两个完全不动了。
All right, so.They're all trying to get away from me and so on, and they're getting injured in the process. But I must exert my independence.
危险我是不怕的。不过这确实惹的祸，知道猫人的法律是什么样的怪东西，吓死人和杀死人。纵然在法律上有分别，从良心上看还是不一样，还是一样，那、no, 还不是一样。
So is scaring someone to death and actually killing them different things? Yes, I don't know. Like, surely it's different.
我想不出。主意来，想不出主意来，找大仙去，解铃还是系铃人
，whatever that means，
他必定有办法，但是大仙绝不会说实话。说若我去求他，等他来找我吧。假如我乘此机会。去找那只飞机，看看我的网友的尸骨，那些的迷民或许会有危险，他必定会找我去，那时我在审问他，他不说实话，那就不回来，我就不回来，要什么？
What's that character? I feel like I know it. Yao Jia? I don't know.
对这个讲信用不以扯谎为可耻的人还有什么别的好办法呢?
All right, let's have a look at that word. It is 熟 and 家. What's that character?
熟
家 鞋 Oh, is it 鞋带的? Oh, 鞋带的鞋.
Itch.
All right, so what does it mean here?
要写.
I don't know. What does it mean by itself? What do you think it means? This one.
要,
oh, 要写. Oh, this is a word. And the 要 is first tone.
要写.
Coerce.
要写.
First time I've encountered that word. All right. I say it's the first time I've encountered that word, but it's not my first time reading this book. Just one second. Actually, I haven't read the book to completion yet. Maybe this will be my first time. We'll see.
把手枪戴好,我便垂头丧气地沿着河岸走。太阳很热了,我知道我缺乏东西。 妈的迷夜。
All right, so I guess that's a swear word.
没他我不能抵抗太阳光与这河上的毒物
All right. Sorry, can you see that? It looks a bit dark on my screen. I'll see if I can make it a little bit brighter. Yeah, it's about as good as I'm going to get.
猫国里不会出圣人，我只要诅骂猫人来，解除我自己的不光带吧，不光荣吧。<笑>我居然想去由那两个死猫人手里收取迷夜了，回到迷林，谁能拦住我去？
I'm not sure what that means, but okay.
懒得跑那几步路，果然，他们手中还拿着迷夜。有一片是已摇去了一半的，我全
This is 炉了过去, is 俘虏, right? This is like prisoner of war. I guess it's here meaning something like spoils of war or something like this.
去了一片沿着河岸走下去，走了许久，我看见了那深灰色的小山，我知道这离飞机坠落的地方不远呢。 可是我不知道那里离河岸有几里，河在河的哪一边上，真热，我又吃了两片迷夜，还觉不出凉快来，没有树，找不到各有阴凉的地方休息一会儿，但是我决定前进。
Alright, so we are still eating these leaves out of necessity, the narcotic leaves.
正在这个袋儿,后面喊了一声,我听得出来,大些的事儿。
First time I've heard that word. Seen it used like that. I'll just say 声音, but here it's 声。
我不理他，还往前走。跑路的本事，他比我强，被他追上了。我想抓住他的头皮，把他的实话摇晃出来。但是我一看他那个样子， 不好意思动手了。他的猪嘴肿着，头上破了一块，身上许多抓伤，遍体像是水洗过的，细毛全粘在皮肤上，不十分不像个成精的水老鼠。我吓死了人，他挨着打。我想想，猫人不敢欺辱外人，可是对他们自己的勇于争斗的。Alright, so I'm a 外国人 in this novel. These people, or the cat people, will not attack me because I am a 外国人, but if I do something wrong, they will attack 大蟹. And I feel sorry for 大蟹, even though he lies to me and tries to control my life. Alright. 他们的谁是谁非？哦，谁是谁非？ So this is who's right, who's wrong. 与我无关。不过对吓死的、受伤的和挨打的大蟹，我一是同人的起了同情心。大蟹张了几次口，才说出一句话来。快回去，迷林被抢了。All right. So the narcotic forest is being robbed. 我笑了，同情心被这一句话给驱逐的静静。他要是因挨打而请我给他报仇，虽然也不是什么好事，可是从一个中国人的心里看，我一定立刻随他回去。迷林被抢了，谁愿当这资本家的走狗呢？抢了更抢了，那抢了变抢了，与我有什么关系？Kind of has a thing. It does
actually affect our protagonist.
He's somewhat both dependent on this narcotic, yet wants to break free from this narcotic. 快回去！迷林被抢了，大蟹的眼珠差一点怒出来。怒，
this "怒" is the Chinese character for crossbow. So I'm guessing the action of a crossbow also is nu. It's figurative, right?
迷林似乎是一切，他的命分明不绝。But no, 他的命分文不绝。
Is that a 成语？分文不绝。
I don't know. Could be.先告诉我早晨的事，我便随你回去。我说
，All right, we have tension and conflicts between our characters. Sometimes, like watching YouTube videos about writing, and this is what you want to do when you have dialogue. You need conflict, and there's like a back and forth, witty banter, and conflict and resolution, and people trying to get their goals. It's not like in real life.
大蟹几乎气死过去，脖子伸了几伸，咽下一大团气后去。迷林被抢了，他要有这个胆子，那个胆子，他一定会登时把我掐死。他一定会登时把我掐死。灯石 What does 灯 here mean?
Thong is like landfall or something like that. Chas is like strangle me to death. Anyway, conflict. We have conflict.
我也打定了主意，他不说实话，我便不动。
好, let's see how this plays out.
结果还是各自得到一半的胜利。当时随他回去，在路上他诉说一切。So
as we walked back, he told me everything. Okay, so we finally know what's going on.
大些说了实话，那些参观的人是他有城里请来的，都是上等社会的人，上等社会的人当然不能起得那么早，可是看洗澡的太稀罕的事，况且大些允许供给他们最肥美的米宴。 每人给他十块国云。
Oh, this is a currency, okay.
猫国的一种签名，作为参观费。米叶每人两片，上当肥美多奖的米叶，不零算钱。
All right, he's charging people to, or charging the cat people to watch me bathe and to for some of the narcotic leaves.
Alright. 但是大谢还没等我发作，便很委婉地说明：“你看，国云是国云，把别人家国云弄在自己的手里，高尚的行为。我虽然没有和你商议过，他走得很快，但是并不妨碍他。” 围曲婉转的陈说.
Is this a four character version of Wei Wan?
围曲婉转.
So Wei Wan is like when you talk indirectly about things. The example I like for Wei Wan. Is when people say something like, "Oh, 这个有点困难." It's like people will tell you, "Oh, that sounds very difficult." What they actually mean is, "我不会帮助你," I'm not going to help you. But they don't want to say that directly, so they say, "Oh, 这个有点困难." So this seems to be,
围曲婉转.
Wei Chu winding. Wandran. Also kind of this one. Tactful. Alright. Mild and indirect. So it does seem to be a four character version of Wei Wan.
Then she Bing Bu Fang Ai Ta Wei Chu Wandran de Chen Shu. 可是我这点高尚的行为你一定不会反对的，你照常的洗澡，我借此得些国云，他的得意开言，面面有意的事，那下次的人谁负责任？ 你负责人，你吓死的，没事。我要是打死人，大些传着说。
Why does it seem so dark? Sorry, give me a second. I'm not sure if that's any better.
我只需损失一些米叶，米叶是一切，法律不过是几行刻在石头上的字，有米叶打死人也不算一回事，你打死人没人管，猫国的法律管不着外国人，连一个米叶。
也不用费。
Alright. 我自恨不是，不是个外国人。你要是在乡下打死人，放在那儿不用管。给那白尾巴鹰一些点心。要是在城里打死人。只需到法庭报告一声，法官还要很客气的给你道谢。
给你道谢。Thanks for killing people.
那些似乎非常的羡慕我。
Alright, so basically I, as a human, am allowed to kill people on Mars and no one's going to care.
So if Dacia kills people, he will have to pay for it.
not really a very serious repercussion in either case, really.
Okay. Dacia 似乎非常的羡慕我，眼中好像含着点泪。我的眼中也要落泪。可怜的猫人，生命何在？公理何在？那两个死去的也是有势力的人，他们的家属不和你捣乱吗？
当然捣乱，抢米叶的便是他们，快走。
他们就一派下人看着你的行动，只要你一离开迷林园了，他们便要抢。他们死了人，抢我的迷叶作为报复，快走。
All right. So we have some kind of enmity going on here. So the minute I leave, they're going to go steal.Steal the narcotic leaves.
人和迷叶的价值，恰相的，恰相等啊。死了便是死了，活着的总得吃迷叶，快走。我忽然想起来，也许因为我受了猫人的传染。也许因为他这两句话打动了我的心，我一定得和他要些国云。假如有朝一日我离开大些，我们俩不是好朋友，我拿什么吃饭呢？他请人参观我洗澡的钱，我有分润一些的权利。设若不是在这种环境之下，自然我不会想到这个。但是环境既是如此，我不能不做个准备。死了便是死了，活着的总是吃迷叶，有理。离迷林不远了，我站住了。大仙，你这两天的功夫一共收了多少钱呢？大仙愣了，一转圆珠，50块国云。还有2块假的，快走。
All right, so we're kind of negotiating now.
我向后转，
开步走. Okay, so I turned back and started walking back.
他追上来,一百一百, 我还是往前走. 他一直听到一千,
I now have negotiating power. So if I do not look after the forest will get pilfered. So I want 500 of the money. This Dacia is full of lies. Dubious character. It's not like he saved me out of the kindness of his heart.
Dacia, 准知道。 多和我争执一分钟，他便多丢一些谜面。他随着一对眼泪答应了一个好。以后再有不告诉我而拿我生财的事，我放火烧你的迷林。
All right, so I'm threatening him. If you're not keeping me informed with your business, then I will burn down the forest.
我拿出火柴盒拍了拍，他也答应了。到了迷林，一个人也没有。大概我来到了之前，他们早有侦探报告，全跑了。 迷林外边上的那二三十棵树已差不多全光了，大谢喊了声，倒在树下。All right,
so we now have a change in our relationship. I now have some negotiating power.
Meaning, 很好看呢，叶一长的比手掌还大一些，后深绿，叶缘上镶着一圈金红的边，那最肥美的叶起了些花斑，像一林各色的大花。 日光由阴灰的空中透过，使这些花叶的颜色更深厚、精美一些，没有照眼的光泽，而是使人越看越爱看，越看心中越觉得舒服。 好像是看一张旧的图画，颜色还很鲜明，可是纸上那层肤光已被年代给剪除了去。All right.
Basically, we're setting the mood, I guess.
迷林的外边一天到晚站着许多许多参观的人。 不是参观的，因为他们全闭着眼，鼻子支出多远，闻着那点浓眉的叶味，嘴张着，流弦最短的也有二尺来长，稍微有点风的时候，大家全部转身。 只用脖子追那股小风，以便吸取风中所含着的香味儿。 好像些雨后的蜗牛轻慢地做着顶部运动，偶尔落下一片熟透的大叶。大家虽然闭着眼，可是似乎能用鼻子闻到响声。一片叶子落地的那点响声，立刻全睁开眼，嘴唇一起把我一起吧唧 ，That's just the sound, right? 一起 ，Where are we? 一起吧唧起来。但是大蟹在他们决定过来尸体那片宝贝之前，总是一团毛似的赶到将它捡起来，四围一声怨鬼似的喊气。
Again, I feel like we're just setting the mood here. It's like a bit of tension. I've got my arrangement with Dacia now, and all these cat people are kind of enjoying watching me bathe. And presumably, we're getting rich.
Dacia, 调了500民兵来保护迷林，可是兵们全驻扎在二里外，因为他们要是离近了迷林，他们便先下手抢劫，但是不能调来他们。
All right.So we have people who are our customers coming from the city. We have soldiers. We have quite a few soldiers. It was a few hundred, wasn't it? Was it 500? Yeah, 500 cat soldiers. We can't trust them. As if we put them anywhere near the forest, they would just go in the forest and steal everything. But they can do their thing.
猫狗的风俗以收获米叶为最重大的事，必须调兵保护。兵们不替任何人保护任何东西是人人知道的。可是不调他们来做不负保护责任的保护，是公然侮辱将士。
I don't know what that means.I don't know, something humiliating if you don't have it. Maybe it's something like a prestige. You don't really need them, but you have these 500 soldiers just for your prestige.
Dacia 是个漂亮人物，自然不愿被人指摘。
I don't know what 指摘 means.
所以调兵是当然的事，可是安置在二里外以免兵缠自乱，风稍微大一些，而且是往兵营那面刮，大些立刻便令后腿半里活一里，以免兵们随风而至，抢劫一空。兵们为何服从他的命令？
Yeah, why? Can they not walk a kilometer? Not even a kilometer, 500 meters, and steal everything?
还是因为有我在那里，没有我，兵早就哗变了。外国人咳嗽一声，吓到猫国500兵，是个言语。
All right, for some reason, the cat people are scared of me. Like, 500 of them are scared of one of me.
500民兵之外，真正保护迷林的是大蟹的
Yeah, this character means 20, but I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm going to say
甘民家将。这20位都是深明大义，
忠诚可靠的人，但是有时候一高兴，也许把大蝎捆起来，也把迷林抢了。到底还是因为我在那里，他们因此不敢高兴，所以能保持着忠诚可靠。All right, just a second, I need the bathroom. All right, wait. 大蝎真要忙死了，看着家将，不许偷食的，偷食一片迷叶，看着风向，好下令退兵，看着林外参观的，以免丢失一个半个的落叶。Can you say 一个半个？一个半个。It's one or even a half or something like that, right? It's not dark here, but it looks really dark on the screen. It's really bright. All right, I fiddled with the software a bit. Hopefully it will do. I tried doing things like opening the curtains. That didn't work. The software just automatically adjusts. Where were we? I forget. 据说 ，no， 他现在已经一起吃到30片迷叶了。据说一起吃过40片迷叶，便可以3天不睡。可是第4天，便要鸣哭哀哉。迷叶这种东西是吃少了有精神。而不愿干事，吃多了能干事，而不久便死。All right， 大蝎无法多吃迷叶，明知必死，但是不能因为怕死而少吃。虽然他极怕死，可怜的大蝎。All right。So there was a functionality here. If you eat, was it 4 leaves? If you eat 4 leaves, you work really hard, but no, was it 4 leaves? No, 40 leaves. If you eat 40 leaves, you will work really hard, but then you will either die or just go into a deep sleep. 我的晚饭减小了，晚上少吃。夜间可以警醒，大蝎以对猫人的方法来对待我了。迷林只仗着我一人保护，所以我得夜间警醒着，所以我得少吃晚饭。功高者受下赏。功高者受下赏，这又是猫人的逻辑。我把一份饭和家伙全摔了。Can you read this? Yeah, it's readable. Sort of. I don't know.第二天我的饭食又照样丰满了，我现在算知道怎样对待猫人了，虽然我心中觉得很不安。刮了一天的小风，这是我经验中的第一次，我初到此地的时候一点风没有，迷叶变红的时候，不过偶然有一阵小风，继续的刮一天，这是头一回 ，sorry， 迷叶带着各种颜色轻轻的摆动，十分好看。大蝎和家将，和家将们在迷林的中心一夜间。赶造成一个大木架，
至少有四五丈高。这原来是为我预备的。这小蜂是猫国有名的蜜蜂，蜜蜂一到天气变了。猫国的节气只是两个，上半年的禁忌蜜蜂，下半年是冻蜂，有风也有雨。So we have seasons. There's a windy and rainy season, and then there's a still season with neither of those. All right. So there's mi feng. There's a kind of fragrance from the narcotic leaves, I guess, as well.
早晨我在梦中听见一片响声，正在我的小屋外边。爬出来一看，大些在前，二十名家将在后，排成一队。大些的耳上，收着一根鹰尾铃。I don't know. 手中拿着一根长木棍。二十名家将手中都拿着一些东西，似乎是乐器。见我出来，他将木棍往地上一戳，二十名家将一起把乐器举起，目光在空中一举，乐器响了，有的吹，有的打。二十件乐器放出不同的声音，吹的是谁也没和谁调和的趋向，尖的与粗的一样难听，而且一样的拉长。直到家将的眼珠似乎怒出来，才换一口气，换气后再吹，身子前后扶扬了几次，可是不肯换气，直到快憋死为止。有两名居然别的倒在地上，可是还吹。猫国的音乐是讲究音乐长而大的，打的都是像什么什么的木器。This is a type of wood, 房子的木器。一劲的打，没有拍节，没有停顿，吹的音乐越尖，打的音乐越紧，好像是随着吹打而丧了命是最痛快而光荣的事。吹打了三通大些的木棍，一扬，乐器停了，二十名家将全蹲在地上喘气。
So where are we going? We're marching along or something, right? Am I still in my dream? I'm having a dream where this is happening.
大些将耳上的鳞毛拔下,
right? I get those mixed up.
And...很目睛的向我走来说，时间一到，请你上台替神明监视着收迷宴。我似乎被那阵乐器给催眠过去，或者更正确的说是被震晕了。心中本要笑，可是不由得随着大些走去， 他把灵毛收，等等。
It's so, right? So 在我的耳上.
Or is it cha-cha-cha-din?
The cha.
I should know this.
Cha, it is cha, sorry. Cha.
Then what's so-so?
So-so.
Oh, it's similar, isn't it?
It just happens. You get them mixed up from time to time, or at least I do.
So cha.
All right.
When you see them in by themselves, it's especially hard.
So before I said it wrong, taba lin mao cha zai wo de er shang. So this is some sort of feather or something like this, or fur, I don't know, and stick it in my ear. So cha
zai qian ning lu. 我随着他二十名音乐家，又在我的后面，到了迷林中心的高架子，大些爬上去，向天。This
is, is it
祷告了一会儿，祈祷的祷
，right? 祈祷的祷 ，if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
祷告, first time I've encountered 祷告. Alright, I'm not sure we have religion on this planet, so this may just be part of the dream.
Where were we here? 向天祷告了一会儿，下面的音乐又做起来。 他爬下来，请我上去，我仿佛忘了我的成员。 像个贪玩的小孩，被一件玩物给迷住，小猴似的爬了上去。大些看我上到了最高处，将木棍。 一挥，20名音乐家全四下散开，在林边，隔着相当的距离站好，面向着树，大些跑了好大半天，他带来不少的兵，他们。 每个人拿着一根大棍，而上插着一个鸟毛，走到林外，大队站住，大些王高架上的一指，兵们把棍举起，大概是向我致敬。 事后我才明白，我原来是在高架上做大神的代表。来替大些，他一定是大神所宠爱的贵人了。保护迷夜，冰人摘叶的时候。 若私藏或偷吃一片，大些告诉他们，我便会用张手雷劈了他们。
So this is my, is it, am I still dreaming or not? I'm not 100% sure. But so 大些 has told them I have magic powers. And I will split them open with lightning if they steal my crops. Doesn't really stop them from stealing my crops, but anyway.
Where were we? 将手雷便是那把艺术,
那二十名音乐家原来便是监视员，有人作弊，便吹打乐器。大些听到音乐，便好请我放张手雷，放张手雷。
I don't know. I split you in two with my lightning magic.
今晚了神。大些下令叫兵们两人一组散开，一人上树去摘，一人在下面等着拔摘下来的整理好。离我最近的那些株树没有人摘，因为大些告诉他们这些这些猪离大神的代表太近。代表的鼻子一出气，他们便要瘫软在地上，一辈子不能再起来。
So Dacia seems to have invented a religion based around there's a god and I am God's servant. Something like this.
所以这必须留着大些自己来拆。猫兵似乎也都被大些催眠过去，全分头去工作。大些大概又一气吃了30片带花斑的上等迷液。穿梭似的来回巡视，木棍牢预备着，王兵们的头上垂。听说每次收迷液，地主必须垂死一两个猫兵，把死猫兵埋在树下。来年便可丰收。有时候地主没预备好外国人做大神的代表，兵们便把地主怼在树下。
So basically these people who are looking after these narcotic forests, So if they don't kill a few of the cat people, then the cat people will think they're kind of weak or something like this and kill them instead.
抢了树叶，把树抛了都做成军器，就是木棍。用这种军器是猫人视为最厉害的军队。
So they're carving some kind of weapon from the tree? I don't know.
Okay, 我搭鹦鹉似的在架上全只身。在架上蜷着身，未免要发笑，我算干什么的呢？但是我不愿破坏了猫国的风俗，我来是为看他们的一切，不能不逢城作戏，必须加入他们的团体，不管他们的行为是怎样的可笑。好在有些小风，不至十分热。况且我还叫大些给我送来个我自己编的盖饭食的草盖，暂当草帽。我总不至被阳光给晒晕过去。
Alright. So this is actually happening, right? It's not just in my dream.
冰与普通的猫人一点分别也没有。若他们没有棍木棍与耳上的鸟铃
It is ling, right? I don't know.
这么棍与鸟铃自然会使他们比普通人的地位优越。可是 在受了大些的催眠时，他们大概还比普通人要多受一点苦。像棉后的残枝桑叶
This is like silkworm eating mulberries.
博大的功夫，我在上面 已能看见原来被蜜叶遮住的树干。再过了一刻，猫兵已全在树尖上了，比较离我近一些，全一手遮着眼，一手遮着眼，大概是怕看见我而有害于它们呢。
原来猫人并不是不能干事，假如有个好的领袖，禁止了吃迷夜，这群人也可以很有用的。假如我把大些赶跑，替他做地主，做将领，但这只是空想。 我不敢决定什么，我到底还不深知猫人。我正在那么想，我看见，因为树叶稀薄了，我很难看清下面。大些的木棍，照这个猫兵的头去了。我知道，就是我跳下去。 不治受伤，也来不及攫住他的棍子了。但是我必须跳下去。在我眼中，大些是比那群兵还可恶的，就是来不及救那个兵。
我也得给大些个厉害，给厉害。All right,
I don't know what that means.
我爬到离地2丈多高的地方，跳了下去，跑过去，那个兵已躺在地上，大些正下令把他埋在地上。 一个不深明白他视为人们的心理的，却往往有善意而有害于人的。这是一跳，在猫兵们以为我是下来放张手雷，我跳在地上，只听屁咚，屁咚扑咚。 屁咚扑咚，四下里，许多兵全掉下树来，大些跌伤了不在少数，因为四面全悲哭的叫着，我顾不得看他们，便一手捉住大些，他呢？ 也以为我是看他责罚猫兵而来帮助他，因为我这早晨处处顺从着他，他自然的想到我完全是他的拐牙子，那我拽牙子
Australia, it's fangs, something like that, maybe.
我捉住了他，嗯，他莫名其妙，嗯，大概他一点儿也不觉得，打死猫兵是不对的事。All right,
so we talked about this, right? So the landowners need to kill the cats, the cat people, and if they don't kill a few cat people, and if they're not like that, they'll get overthrown and they'll get killed themselves. So it seems that's what our friend Da Xie is doing.
Well, when Da Xie, why is he killing people? Because that bin ate a leaf,
like a leaf stalk, a tiny little thing.
Why ate a leaf?
I just want to say,
我更清晰地说，还是没人上前，我心中冷了，若我正领着这么一群兵，我大概永远不会使他们明白我，他们不敢上前。 并不是出于爱护大些，而是完全不了解我的心意，为那死兵报仇，在他们的心中是万难想到的，这使我为难了，我若放了大些，我必定会被他轻视。 我若杀了他以后，我用他的地方，正多着，正多着的，那，I don't know，无论他怎样不好，对于我在火星上，至少是猫国这一部分，所要看的，他一定比这群兵，更。 有用一些，我假装镇静，问大些：“你是愿意叫我捆在树上，眼看着兵们把迷夜都抢走了，还是愿意认罚？”All
right, so I'm turning on my friend 大些。 I'm instructing the soldiers to tie him up and so on. I seem to be scheming something, and I'm not entirely sure what I'm scheming right now.
兵们听到我说叫他们抢，立刻全精神起来，立刻就有动手的。我一手抓着大些。 一脚踢翻了两个，大家又不动了，大些的眼，一闭成一道线，我知道他心中怎样的恨我，我请来的大神的代表，反倒当着兵们把他惩治了。 极难堪的事，自然他绝不会想到，因一节叶梗而杀人是他的过错。但是他决定，不和我较量。我承认，他承认了受罚。我问他，兵们替我收迷夜，有什么报酬？他说。 一人给两片小迷叶，这时候四位兵们的耳朵都在脑勺上立起来了，大概是猜想，我将叫大些
多给他们一些迷液。我叫他在迷液收完之后给他们一顿饭吃，像我每天吃的晚饭。 Where are we? Sorry. 冰门的耳朵都落下去了，却由嗓子里出了一点声音，好像是吃东西what's that? 依住了似的。不满意我的办法。对于死去那个兵，我叫大些赔偿他的家小100个国云。大些也答应了。但是我问了半天，谁知道他的家属在哪里？没有一个人出声。对于别人有意的事，哪怕是说一句话呢，猫人没有帮忙的习惯。这是我在猫国又住了几个月才晓得的。大些的100个国云因此省下了。Alright, so I'm kind of turning on him and I'm starting to issue commands and so on. Alright, next chapter. I think I'll keep going, but I might have a little rest first. Pause for a second. Alright, back to it. Next chapter. So if you weren't paying attention, so we've got a bit of conflict between our protagonist and so on. I'm kind of setting the army against our friend Dacia, our friend in quotes. The soldiers think I'm a servant of a god. so this wasn't not my doing. This was Dacia wanted to make them think that so they will be afraid of me. And now that they're afraid of me, I've turned them on to Dacia. Alright. 迷夜收完，天天刮着小风，温度比前降低了十几度。灰空中时时浮着些黑云，可是并没落雨。冬季的开始。So this 冬季 is a concept in this book, right? There was two seasons. There was 冬季 and 冬季. And in this novel, 冬季 was the concept where there was rain and there was wind. Windy, rainy season. 冬季的开始。是地主们带着迷夜到城市去的时候了。大些心中随十二分的不满意我。十二分Why is it not 十分十二分可是不能不假装着亲善。为是使我好同他一起到城市去。没有我他不会平安走到那里。因为保护迷夜也许丢了他的性命。迷夜全晒了全晒干打成了大包。兵丁们两人一组搬运一包，二人轮流着把包顶在头上，大些在前，有四个兵丁把他抬起，他的脊背平平地放在四个猫头之上，另有两个高身量的兵拖着他的腿，还有一名在后面撑住他的脖子。这种旅行的
方法在猫国是最体面的，假如不是最舒服的。二十名家将全拿着乐器。I don't know what that means. 将全拿着。All right, whatever that means. 在兵丁们的左右。So 左右 here means left and right, right? Not about kind of thing. 兵丁如有一手规则的比如说用手指挖破叶包为蚊蚊迷味便随着奏乐报告大些OK 什么东西要在猫国里放在必须得有用处音乐也是如此音乐家是侦探的Alright, so now it makes more sense why they're playing music. Their music is not for entertainment. They're playing music and the music will change if they catch people doing, like getting into the narcotic leaves.我的地位是在大队的中间，以便前后照应。大谢也给我预备了七个人，我情愿在地上跑，不贪图这份优待。大谢一定不肯迎金，我迎金据点的给我说着。皇帝给台人二十一皇帝有台人二十一啊 is that 十 no I don't know what that means 皇帝有台人二十一诸王十五贵人七So maybe this is like in this universe, this is some concept. 这是古代的遗风，身份的表示，不能也不许破坏的。All right, I made another coffee, I need to put it over here. Hmm. 我还是不干。No, 贵人地上走，大些引用言语了，祖先除了丑，我告诉他，我的祖先绝不因此而出了丑，他几乎要哭了，又引了两句诗，阳面吃迷宴。平生做贵人滚你们贵人的蛋我想不起相当的诗句只这么不客气的回答大谢叹了一口气心中一定把我快骂化了骂化了可是口中没敢骂出来Alright, so we're doing our thing, and Da Xie is not happy. Alright, 排队就费了两点多钟的功夫，大谢躺平又下来。前后七次，猫兵们始终排不齐。猫兵现在准知道我不完全帮忙大些大些自然不敢再用木棍打猎他们的猫头Maybe I should pronounce this in full 猫头 the cat the heads of the cat why do I not bash in the heads with a stick 所以平原大些 怎么阻骂他们？他们反正是不往这里排列，那些投降了，下令前进，不管队伍怎样的乱。
Alright, so they think I'm this like servant of God, of the God they kind of made up on this planet. So that they, Dacier has to kind of respect that. Like he taught all these soldiers that I was this powerful entity, even though it's totally made up, but he has to keep pretending this. And yeah, hijinks are ensuing.
更要启程，空中飞来几只白尾鹰，大蟹又跳下来，下令，出了育鹰大不祥，明日再走。我把手枪拿出来了，不走的便永远不要走了。大蟹的脸都气绿了。
OK， 干张了几张嘴，
一句话没说出来。他知道与我辩驳是无意的。
OK, so some of these birds were flying around. We're like, Darcy is like, okay, we need to rest till tomorrow, and I'm like, no, we're not resting. He's like, I'm not sure why. It's just to assert my independence, respect my authority.
他知道与我辩驳是无意的，同时他知道泛指忌讳出行是多么危险的事。他费了十几分钟才又爬到猫头上去。
So it's literally he's standing on a cat's head, right?
浑身颤抖着。大队算是往前挪动的，不知道是被我气得躺不稳了。还是台的人故意和他开玩笑。走了不大的功夫，大蟹滚下来好几次，但是滚下来立刻又爬上去。大蟹对于祖先的遗风是极富保存之责的。沿路上凡是有能鞋子的地方，树皮上、石头上、破墙上，全写上了大白字。欢迎大蟹，大蟹是鼎立国史的伟人。大蟹的兵士。执着正义之棒，之棍，有大蟹才能有今年的丰收。这原来都是大蟹预先派人写好给他们自己看的，给他自己看的。经过了几个小村庄。村人们全被移破墙坐着，军队在他们眼前走过，他们全闭着眼，连看也没不看。说若他们是怕兵呢？为何不躲开？不怕呢？为何又不敢正眼看？我弄不清楚。极致细看，我才明白过来。这些原来是村庄欢迎大蟹的代表。
Okay, 因为他们的头上的细灰毛里隐隐约约的也写着白字，每人头上一个字，几个人合起来成一句欢迎大些等等的字样。
So they're all wearing hats with Chinese characters on them and putting them together, it's
欢迎大些。
But aren't they meant to be welcoming me?
当然这样。因为这也是大些事先派人给他们写好了，所以白色已经惭愧不甚清楚了。虽然他们全闭着眼，可是大些还真是似的向他们点头，表示致谢的意思。这些村庄是都归大些保护的。村庄里的破烂污浊，与村人们的兽脏没有精神，可以证明他们的保护人保护了他们没有。我更恨大些了。
All right, so we've arrived at this village, and the people in the village are all supporting 大些, right? He's kind of pre-manipulated them. So let's see if we have some sort of conflict. Maybe even a battle, I don't know.
要是我独自走，大概有半天的功夫，总可以走到猫城了。
Okay, but 半天, walking for half a day is not such a big deal.
和猫兵们走路最足以练习忍耐性的。猫人本来可以走得很快，但是猫人当了兵便不会快走了，因为上阵时快走是自找速死，所以猫兵们全是以文慢见长，慢慢的上阵，遇见敌人的时候再快快的
All right, so you see the enemy, what do you do? We finally walk faster away. It's meant to be like a joke, right? They walk really slowly, and then when they see the enemy, they run away.
下午一点多了，天上虽有些黑云，太阳的热力还是很强，猫兵们的嘴都张得很宽，身上的细毛都被汗粘住，我没有见过这样不体面的一群兵。远处有一片迷林，大些下令绕道穿着林走，我以为这是他体谅兵丁们到林中可以休息一会儿，极致快到了树林，他滚下来和我商议，我愿意帮助他抢这片迷林，不愿意抢这些迷叶还不十分重要，给兵们一些作战的练习是很有益的事。大些说，没有，没回答他。我先看了看兵们，一个个的嘴全闭上了，似乎一点疲乏的样子也没有了。随走随抢是猫兵们的正当事业，我想。
对，我想，
我也看出来，大些与他们，他的兵必须，都极恨我，假如我拦住他们抢劫，虽然我都把手枪可以，抵得住他们， 但是他们要安心害我。我是防不胜防的。况且猫人互相切夺是他们视为合理的事，就是我不因个人的危险而舍弃正义。谁又来欣赏我的行为呢？我知道我是已经受了猫人的传染，我的勇气往往为谋自己的安全而减小了。我告诉大些，随意办吧。这已经是退步的表现了。哪知我一退步，他就立刻紧了一板。他问我是否愿意领手去抢呢？对于这一点，我没有迟疑的拒绝了。你们抢你们的，我不反对，也不加入。我这样跟他说。
So are they stealing someone else's crops? So they're going to the city, right? They're marching to the city with their crops. Maybe they want the money. They're marching to the city with the crops and the soldiers, and they're going through this town. And now it looks like they're going through a forest and going to steal someone else's crops along the way.
兵们似乎有以往树林这边走，便已臭出 no 已嗅出抢夺的味儿来。不等大些下令，已经把叶包全放下。已经把叶包全放下。拿好大棍。有几个已经跑出去了。我也没看见大些这样勇敢过。他虽然不亲自去抢，可是他的神色是非常的厉害严厉，毫无恐惧，眼睛瞪圆，头上的犀毛全竖立起来。他的大棍一挥，兵们一声喊，全扑过迷林去。到了迷林，大家绕着林飞跑，好像都犯了疯病。我想这大概是往外右林中的看护人跑了三圈，林中不见动静。大些笑了，兵们又是一声喊，全闯入林里去。
So we're just scoping out the perimeter. Yep, no one's there. We're taking it all.
林中也是一声喊，大些的眼不那么远了，眨巴的几下，他的兵退出来，大棍全撕了手，双手倒了脑勺。狼嚎鬼叫的往回跑。有外国人，大家一起喊。
Aha! We have a change of the status quo. So they all went into the forest, and then they all came out screaming, Ah! There's a foreigner!
Yeah, that's a bit of an issue. Because apparently we've taught them that foreigners have superpowers. 大些似乎不信，可是不那么勇敢呢。自言自语地说，有外国人。我知道这里一定没有外国人。他正这么说着。
林中有人追出来了，大蟹慌了。真有外国人。林中出来不少的猫兵，为首的是 maybe it's 为首的是两个高个子，偏no 扁体白毛的人，手中拿着一条发亮的棍子。这两个一定是外国人了。我心中想，外国人是会用化学制造与铁相似的东西的。我心中也有点不安。假如大蟹请求我去抵挡这那两个白人。白人 ,alright。我又当我又当怎办？Alright, so in this book, 我 is a Chinese person, right? So normally you would not consider Chinese person as 白人. I'm not 100% sure in this, in the context of this novel, we're on Mars, what counts as what. 我知道他们手上发亮的东西是什么。抢人家的迷林虽不是我的主意，可是我到底是大蟹的保护人。看着他们打败而不救他，甚至也有失我的身份。我将来在猫国的一切还要依赖着他。Alright, so...There are two, presumably white people in the forest, and the cat people are afraid.
快去挡住，大蟹向我说，快去挡住。
All right, so I have to stop these two people.
我知道这是义不容辞的。义不容辞。All right. 我顾不得思路。拿好手枪走过去。出我意料之外那两个白猫见我出来。不再往前进了，大蟹也赶过去赶过来。我知道这不能有危险了。
讲和讲和。
大蟹和我身后低声地说。
So 讲和 would be like make peace or something like this, I guess.And so let's look it up. 和, 和 does mean peace. You know that if you see people getting tattoos, like peace.
Yeah, make peace.
It very seldom actually means peace in Chinese. Most of the time it means and. But...Yeah, it can mean peace. And this is one of these cases where it means peace. Make peace.
我有些发糊涂。为什么不叫我和他们打呢?
Yeah, there it is. And. Or with them.
讲和怎么讲呢?事情到头往往不像理想那么难。我正发糊涂。那两个白人说的话，把你六包迷液，归我们三个人用。
All right, so they're charging us six bags of leaves for as a punishment for intruding. And they're saying the three of them get is shared between three of them. Well, we thought there was only two. Let's see what happens.
我看了看只有两个白人怎么说三个呢?
Yeah.
大蟹在后面低声地催我和他们讲讲。我讲什么呢?傻子似的我也说了声把你六包迷液。
Alright, so I don't know what to say, but I've charged them. I've given them a fine of six bags.
归我们三个人用。 Or maybe I'm just repeating them.
两个白人听我说的这句，笑着点了点头，似乎非常的满意。我更莫名其妙，大谢叹了口气，分寸。
No, 分布。
But that's not how you write 分布。
分布搬过6包米也来。
Yeah, all right, so it's a variant. So you don't have to have the call.
Yeah, all right.
I think you're probably better off doing that. If you're on the HSK6 and you're getting marked on your accurate typing or handwriting or whatnot.
Oh,
okay. So the three people were two of them and one of me.
我这才明白。 原来三个人是连我算在内的，我自然很客气地请他们先挑，他们随便地拿了4包交给他们的猫兵，而后向我说，我们的迷夜也就收完，我们城里再见。 我也傻子似的说了声城里再见，他们走回林里去了。Alright,
so that was a really weird encounter, right? So they took 4 bags of leaves from us. Yeah, very confusing. We did manage to communicate. And were they actually humans, right? They were actually humans, right?
Yeah, Byron.
They're Byron, not just humans, but white people.
All right. 我心中怎么想怎么糊涂。这是什么把戏呢?
Yeah, it's very confusing.
直到我到了猫城以后，与外国人打听。 才明白了其中的曲折。猫国人是打不过外人的，他们唯一的希望是外国人们自己打起来，立志自强需要极大的努力。猫人太精明，不肯这样傻卖力气。 所以，举球大神叫外国人互相残杀，猫人好得硬说，得个机会看别国与他们自己一样的弱了。外国人明白这个，他们在猫国里的厉害冲突是实是有的，但是他们绝不肯互相攻击，让猫国得之便宜。 他们看得清清楚楚，他们自己起了纠纷是应对应的，就是打胜了也要受很大的损失。反正他们若是联合起来，一同欺辱猫国，便可以毫无损失地得到很大好处。
不但国际间的政策是如此，
就是在猫国做事的个人也守着这个条件。保护迷邻是外国人的好职业，但是大家约定绝不替地主抵抗猫国的人。遇到双方都有外国人保护的时候，双方便谁也没准侵犯谁。有不熟这个条件的，便由双方的保护人商议惩罚的，惩罚地主或为和为首的人。这样既能避免外国人与外国人因猫国人的事而起争执，又能保护人的地位优越，不致受的猫国人的利用。
That was a little complicated. Just a second. All right, what do you think? There's a lot of, like, what's the word? Exposition here. a bit of exposition. I'm not sure how much of that I need to know. But that was how Weigeren can avoid conflict while in the cat country.
为保护人设想这些不错的办法，从猫国人看呢，我不由得带大仙们，大仙们
，What is 大仙？大仙 is a single person. You can't have a 大仙们，
抱不平呢。
Yeah, I don't know what that means. Maybe it's people like him or something like that.
可是继而一想，大仙们甘心忍受这个，甘心不自强，甘心请求外人打自己家的人，又是谁的过错呢？有同等的豪横气的才能，彼此重视。猫国人根本失了人味，难怪他们受别人这样的戏弄。我为这件事心中不痛快了好几天。
Alright, so there's an awful lot of politics in foreigner management in this country.
王辉说，大谢受了罚，又郑重其事的上了猫头，一点羞惭羞愧的神气没有，倒好似他自己战胜了似的。他只向我说，假如我不愿意，我不愿要那两包米叶，他知道我不喜欢吃它，他情愿出30个国云买回去。我准知道这包米叶至少也值300国云，可是我没说卖，也没说不卖，我只是不屑于理他。我连哼一声也没哼。太阳平息了，看见了毛城。
All right. So we can see the city now, but so there's a whole bunch of complicated interactions between these things, and we're all not knowing what's going on. there was one way to prevent conflict between people, which is I guess why they considered me as when they asked for six bags to share between three. So they would have bought it if I didn't eat it. They would have bought it or something like that. Anyway, let's call it a video. The next chapter, Mao Cheng, we'll get to the city, see what happens in the city. Is the book. Page 64. All right, I'm a little tired. Thank you for watching. That's it, y'all. Oh yeah, remember liking, subscribing, YouTubing things, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.